मैं थोड़ा हरजाप तो हरेक मंडे 7 बजे तुसी तो मैं आपस में गल्ला करांगे साड़ी कम्यूनिटी दियां साड़े बच्चों दियां साड़े बाहर रहिंदे NRI-आं दियां साड़े देश दियां तो जो अजकल दे इशू हैगे सानू अफेक्ट करदे उन्हां दियां सो लेट्स टॉक विद हरजाप
Welcome back to the show. Gal sadi ho rahi hai football bare. Tuhanu pata hai ki yes, thode sare bacche football khelde hai. Ajkal ta bacche vi nahi, bachiyan vi football khelde hai. Mere khayal ajj Facebook te kai maawan ne kiya ki sadi bachiyan khelde hai and they're playing for good clubs like Derby. We've got one playing for, you know, and we've got a kid who plays for Hibernian. There's someone who wrote from, there's a kid from Gravesend. He's wanted by Chelsea and Spurs, you know, in the under 13s there. So slowly, I think, that agents will get there.
Absolutely.
Maybe for Biak's Albad, but they were a bit late.
It's definitely a numbers game as well. The more we have actively playing the game, the better chance of one of them excelling to the highest level.
ਜਦੋਂ ਤੂੰ ਖੇਡਦਾ ਤੈਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਡਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਲੱਗਦਾ ਕਿ ਮੇਰੇ ਕੋਲ 60 ਲੱਗ ਗਈ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਮੇਰਾ ਸਾਰਾ ਕੁਝ ਓਵਰ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਮੇਰੇ ਕੋਲ ਪੜ੍ਹਾਈ ਵੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈਗੀ
it's a part of the game and I've had injuries in the past as well and it's not just how you recover from them physically, it's how you recover from them mentally as well. And luckily, obviously, being at professional clubs, I've always recovered very well from injuries. And it's more so the work you do is to prevent injuries. Prevention is better than the cure. So football is much of an impact sport, requiring a lot of twisting and turning. And the amount of strain you put on your body is tremendous. And eventually it does take its toll, but things like yoga and Pilates, they definitely help to extend your playing career. And you've got professionals like Ryan Giggs who are actively doing yoga and he's playing on almost 40 years old. So your lifestyle does come into play as well. Obviously, there's a lot of players you hear do live the rock and roll lifestyle, but you know.
But not every day.
No.
Yeah, what do you mean? That's glassy lavi, you know, it's not really...
Well, obviously, it's that balanced lifestyle. Sometimes it's the best thing for you to do rather than go out and do a training session. So it is well needed, but you do have to watch what you eat, the times you sleep, the amount of training, the type of training is important. It's not just going out there and running on hard ground. Sometimes working a pool or on different muscle groups is always better.
Discipline ਕਿੰਨਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਸੀ when you was at Bradford City? ਕਿੰਨਾ discipline ਸੀ because obviously ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸਾਰੇ ਨਿਆਣੇ ਆ, right?
Yeah.
And everyone, all the ਨਿਆਣੇ want to put a bit of coral and go out and try this and try that.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so was it like a school? Pretty much?
Absolutely.
Now boarding school, give them that.
I remember we were 17 and one of the players was spotted in a pub on a Friday night, a day before a game.
Yeah.
And the coach didn't say anything, but on a Monday morning, we went down to the training ground, and we didn't see no footballs that day.
Yeah.
He ran us all until we were sick, and all because this one player did this, went out. So you know, we learned very fast that you know you got to.
So discipline, both edge.
Absolutely, yeah.
Right, so ਇਹ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ 10-12 ਗਲਾਸ ਵੀ ਕਿਹਾ ਮੈਂ ਹੁਣ ਫੁੱਟਬਾਲ ਖੇਡਣਾ
ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਸਵੇਰ ਨੂੰ ਨਾ ਦੱਸ ਵੈਨ ਯੂ ਆ ਯੂਥ ਟੀਮ ਪਲੇਅਰ ਵਾਂਸ ਯੂ ਪਲੇਇੰਗ ਇਨ ਯੂ ਨੋ
ਪ੍ਰੋਫੈਸ਼ਨਲ ਟੀਮ
ਔਨ ਟੌਪ ਫੋਰ ਦੈਨ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਅਲਾਡ ਸਮ ਲਿਮਿਟਸ ਐਸ ਵੈਲ
ਬਟ ਨਾਟ ਟੂ ਦੈਟ ਐਕਸਟੈਂਟ ਵੇ ਅਫੈਕਟਸ ਯੂਰ ਗੇਮ ਰਾਈਟ
ਵੈਲ ਸਮ ਪਲੇਅਰਸ ਕੈਨ ਗੈਟ ਅਵੇ ਵਿਦ ਇਟ ਆਈ ਮੀਨ ਆਈ ਲਾਈਕ ਸੇ ਆਮ ਨਾਟ ਗੋਇੰ ਟੂ ਨੇਮ ਨੇਮਸ ਬਟ ਅਲਕੋਹੋਲ ਡਰਗਸ ਗੈਂਬਲਿੰਗ
It's all part of their life, isn't it?
A lot of players have been known to go into that. But see, this is an educational factor as well. When football is all what you know and it's your life, it doesn't necessarily mean what they do in the outside of life is going to affect what they're doing. So they let off steam by doing these things, but because they're being classed as heroes and they're performing to a high level playing, they think they're untouchable in a way, which it's an educational thing. Really.
I want to ask you the most important question, which up on your parents want to know.
Tadi
baby ni hundi ya?
Well,
football ain't big. It's only you think football can be. You rational like you. You know what I mean? You got to put food on the table. So
depends. So,
yeah, I mean, what sort of wages would someone be taking on?
When I've been at a full-time club, personally, I've been getting almost £1,000 a week.
£1,000 a week?
Yeah.
Oh, good. There's a beginner now you get up here.
But obviously, when you're playing part-time, it's between maybe £200 to £300 a week.
Matlab Dota, jet si part time bhi khelde, Dota is upon ta kehte gyan hi hafta da.
Well, yeah.
Right. And so jet si top level te khelde, and it's anything from £1,000 to, and jet si and top te khelde, kya nahi to hafte da bhi 2 lakh pound milta. I mean, yeah. I mean, I remember I was watching a player on TV, and like I was telling Dad, I said, "Eno hai na, a 1.5 lakh pound milta hafte da." And he's going like, 1.5 lakh pound to nahi jada hunda saal da. And I said, saal da nahi, hafte da. And he's going, what, hafte da? And I said, yeah. And then, like, it's, that is amazing money.
Well, they're the positive sides, obviously, to football. You know, a player's life isn't just the glamorous things, as like you see, as I've explained. But some players happen to be at the right place at the right time. They get a lot of money from a young age. And obviously, it could be fantastic for their lives, but it could also be very detrimental, as you've heard, I'm sure you've heard in newspapers, you know. And a playing career is normally over by, I think the average age is 33 now.
Yeah, that's right.
So obviously, if you're thinking of the rest of your life here, and you're trying to make as much money in that gap where you're playing football to see you for the rest of your life, obviously not. Football is something what everybody sacrificed for their entire life. So therefore, you know, it's only right to try and make as much money as possible to leave them in good stead.
And it's just like any other thing. It's a job, you know?
Absolutely.
Playing football, I mean, it's a full-time job.
Yeah.
Just like sare doctor, vakil bande ya accountant bande ya, sare apni zindagi laundi ya is passe. Tuhada vi eh job hi hai ek kisam da.
Absolutely, but I believe it's more than just a job. It's been a life, because everybody wants to do it. You can't just necessarily treat it as a job. I believe it, that's not right. You've got to live your life the right way, especially to be a professional footballer, because it's such a really good career if you're in it. And like I explained, everybody wants to be a football player. So I believe you have to be the right role model. Obviously, not every player looks at you like that, but because of my upbringing, very grounded Sikh family, that's the way, you know, I've been brought up to respect things.
If, say, for the next couple of years, it doesn't work out for you,
yep.
To go so check out what you're going to do.
Yep, because I'm playing part-time at the moment, I'm going to be doing my UEFA B course this year.
Right.
And the PFA, the Professional Football Association, they're going to be funding that.
Right.
So I'm thinking about the future when I'm not going to be playing, because I'm turning 25 this year, so
right.
Normally a player this age always thinks about what's going to happen when, when you're not going to be playing. So that's definitely an option. I'm very much interested in psychology and sports psychology as well.
Right.
Being a player, it always interests me how you can do certain things on a training ground when your mind's free, but when you're playing in front of 5,000-6,000. Why you don't play to your capabilities in a way, and there are certain things that I'm very much interested in and I think about regularly. So it's something for the future.
What can we do to get more Asians into football? What needs to be done? I'm sure there's an Asian kid out there. I'm sure there's an Apna kid out there who's talented. I'm sure there's a few out there that are probably very talented.
There's plenty that's talented, I think.
So what can we do to get them into good clubs, and what can we get them to do to get them into football?
Well, like I've explained, a lot of it is to do with when you're younger, and there's a scouting system that goes on.
Yeah.
A lot of kids play, not just to necessarily play with your friends or just with an Asian group, I'd say get out there and be playing in. Try and be playing in the better teams around the area, whether it's...
Are there Asian scouts? Do you know any?
Two.
It may be at the whole system, right?
There's not many, because there's not been that many players.
But I'm sure there's Afro-Caribbean scouts, right?
Yeah.
And there must be a lot more of them than there are Asian scouts.
Yeah.
Right? And as the white scouts and that. So maybe we need...
So So as I
explained, more Asian scouts,
it,
right?
It's a numbers game, but then again, see, a lot of it is to do with is who you know at a football club. A scout is going to get a job because he knows the manager.
Or maybe he's been an ex-player.
Exactly. Right. So if there's not many Asian players, yeah, then it's difficult for them to pursue up to that level. But I think that times are changing now and clubs are actively searching for Asian and black scouts to try and get a bit more of the minorities involved into their clubs. So I do believe clubs are trying, but we need more players, we need more numbers in there.
What about India as a market? We haven't seen India football kamyab hoya, cricket which the kamyab hoya, in the old days hockey, but what about, India as a market?
A football player from England and being of Indian origin, the national team do not allow players of Indian origin to go and play for the club, which to me is it's a little bit ridiculous, as in India, Indian is what I am, and I'd love to go back, and not just myself, there's a handful of players, Ricky Baines, Netan Sinsara, a few Indian footballers who have been at professional clubs who would love to go and play for their country, and it'd be very good for our careers as well. Having a national team cap on our CV would be fantastic, and it probably get us a better chance of getting a bigger club. Now, Pakistan, they're allowing players of Pakistan
origin
Zeshri Emin, Adnan Ahmed, Luke Dean, all of them played for professional clubs, and now their national team is doing better than just having players of Pakistani born. So, I mean, I'm not sure why the India Football Federation treat us this way and don't allow us to go back and represent our country, but I mean, it's not doing the country any good, and neither is it for our careers.
What about footballers from India, selecting footballers from India, and they look at India, and but only this sport which comes out, like you never see an Indian swimmer, and yet Adi Malik is surrounded by water. So they can go into the Goan rivers and find a fish from the bottom of the ocean, but they can't go swimming, and you never see an Indian runner or like a high athlete or a pole vaulter. You know, athletics, which Olympic, which stuff, you're shooting chundaya, you're weightlifting chundaya. But recently, because Anish Vyas from Bedford, Anish Kindan, he was saying that one of the project called Delhi, which where they go and offer scholarship, they're offering a scholarship to a guy from India, and one of the best, they held a trials of about 300 people, and they showed all of that. But that now that clubs like, so maybe Chelsea and Manchester United, and Liverpool are now sort of interested in India as a market, because they've seen there's a lot of money there, there's a big population there. Do you think that'll work out?
Well, I hope so. I definitely know it is developing. It's not there yet, as in the infrastructures and the grassroots coaching isn't to the highest level. I have a friend who actually owns a club in India, Dhruv Ratra, and he's also got a club in Denmark, and he's trying to get Indian footballers out into Europe, and that's going to benefit Indian football.
They probably overstay. because there's a guy from here who used to play for Tottenham, and I think maybe Bolton, Rohan Ricketts, and he signed from the Indian League. That's called the I-League. So he's playing there, so there is maybe something starting.
They do have a quota for foreign players. I think it's four in every club, and they opt for African players.
Yeah.
But obviously, India itself, it's definitely changing, I believe. But like you were talking about other sports, swimming, running, I don't think the money's not getting invested into the infrastructure.
At that sort of level, Hannah.
Exactly, so it's going to be difficult. Tata
cricket, they blow the budget on cricket and hockey and stuff like that.
Yeah, but obviously they've been that's what they've been good at. So they kind of try and stick to what they know. Whereas that's not the way to go forward. You have to break down these barriers and go through the phase where you could be the worst, but you're still in it. So
I think there was an Indian player who came to play for Bury or something. Bai Chang Bhutia, he was a captain.
Right. Yeah.
But he didn't do any great shapes, I think. I don't even know if he scored a goal. And he's supposed to be a striker.
The thing is, when a foreign player comes to the Premier League, they're always given least 6, 7, 8 months to bed in.
Yeah.
I don't really believe he was treated in the best right, and obviously it's difficult for somebody who's been from India to come
and step up their level as well. Yeah.
Personally, I can tell you, going to a different, me playing in Belgium, it's difficult to start with. You don't know the language, everything's different. It does take a little bit of time to settle in, and because you're used to playing football when you're happy around people that you know, when that's taken away from you,
your game might suffer.
It does affect your game, so that's why you have to get other things in place, and it just takes a little bit of time.
What we're going to do is we're going to go to a break, and then we're going to talk about your stint in Belgium and everything else. But sorry, galla kardeya, break the bat.
ਮੈਂ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਹਰਜਾਪ ਤੇ ਹਰੇਕ ਮੰਡੇ 7 ਵਜੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਤੇ ਮੈਂ ਆਪਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ ਸਾਡੀ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਦੀਆਂ ਸਾਡੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਸਾਡੇ ਬਾਹਰ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਐਨਆਰਆਈਆਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਸਾਡੇ ਦੇਸ਼ ਦੀਆਂ ਤੇ ਜੋ ਅੱਜ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਦੇ ਇਸ਼ੂ ਹੈਗੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਅਫੈਕਟ ਕਰਦੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਸੋ ਲੈਟਸ ਟਾਕ ਵਿਦ ਹਰਜਾਪ